Welcome back, my French traders. Caroline Alexandre here, a graduate student of the Grok Trade Mentoring Program. It is Monday, July 25th, 2011, and we're looking at the Q's chart, as we always do. So, hope you all had a wonderful weekend, and we're all back in the game. I'm just so excited to be here with you again and just help you do some technical analysis here a little bit. And what I would like to do is just write me a little bit of a feedback right below the video, and that will just help me a lot to see if the videos are any helpful to you. So if you could just, you know, put a little note out there, that would be awesome. I would just really appreciate it. So it will help me a lot too. But anyways, yeah, let's get back to our chart. So what we see here on our chart is that we are still inside that rising wedge formation that we talked about last week. And it doesn't really surprise me that we stop today at this upper area of resistance. We pierced that line in here, we busted through it, making a new high, which was at the 59.81, and then we closed the day a little bit lower below that trend line out here that you see in blue, which is a significant area of resistance. So pay close attention to it again tomorrow. Because if we bust through it and continue to the upside, making a new high, we could continue higher if we break through, first of all, the blue trend line right here, which is a significant area of resistance right now, as well as the high of today, which was at the 59.81. That would be an indication that we could continue higher all the way up to that next major area of resistance up here, which you see here in blue, and that is a significant area of resistance that I really want you to pay close attention to. It's very far away, but once we break through the 59.81, everything is possible, so we can head all the way higher, all the way up to that upper area of resistance, which is right here, I would say, at about 53.40 mark. So keep that in mind. But if we do not go higher, if we instead pull back down to that lower area support that you see here, again in blue, which is that, this is this lower blue trend line that you see here, the thick one, and it's sitting right at about 58.70 mark. So if we pull back down a little bit to that lower area support, and then if we broke through it, we would be in trouble. So that rising wedge would be confirmed only and only if we break through that lower area support and then close below it. So that would be a really nice confirmation, all together with the MACD, which is flat. It's not rising anymore, as you can see. So we're stopping at this upper area of resistance right here, and the MACD is flat, which doesn't tell me anything. It's not confirming that up move and that new high that we made today. And check this out. Look at the volume. It's dropping drastically. It's way below the average. So we are having a really drastic drop in volume below the average on this up run, which I don't really like. And according to the 8 moving average, which you see here in green, we are still above it, which means that we are still in a bullish territory. But this rising wedge formation is not bullish, it's bearish. That's very important to remember. So we're waiting for that breakout to the downside through that lower area support down below right here, the 58.70 mark. So pay close attention to that. So that's what we see here. And according to the 8 moving average, again, we're in a bullish territory still. So again, pay close attention to the high of today, the 59.81 mark, as well as that upper area of resistance that you see here in blue, as well as that lower area support, again the 58.70 mark. That's a key point to remember, and please put that on your chart. And also pay close attention to the MACD, which is flat again, and look at the volume to see if we're going to get an increase in volume on any down day. If we do, that would be a really nice confirmation, but still we need to wait for that formation to be confirmed, we'll need to wait for that breakout to the downside through that lower area support. And what else do I see here on our chart is that we are having this little inverse head and shoulders forming in here. So as you can see, that neckline right here, we have that low shoulder in here, a head, and then another shoulder, and then that neckline was pierced here today, but we never closed above it, so it was never confirmed. So pay close attention to that as well. So that's what I have here for you for today. So again, if you could just write me a little note right below the video, let me know how am I doing. That would be really, really helpful. So yeah, have a wonderful evening, and I'll talk to you again tomorrow.